my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss one more important topic, that is the structure of microfilaments. In previous class we have discussed the structure of microtubules. These two are the belongs to the cytoskeleton of cell. Okay, let us see the what is the microfilaments and how microfilaments are formed, the function of microfilaments, along with that the differences between the microfilaments and also microtubules we are going to see. Okay, if you are watching our videos for the first time, please do subscribe my channel. Okay, let us start with the topic. So microfilaments, actually these microfilaments which are present in the intracellular, okay, these filaments actually formed by a protein called as a actin, whereas the microtubules which are formed by the tubulin protein. Okay, this actin protein which is forming in the cell for doing the many functions. Let us see the what are the functions basically they are doing. These microfilaments which are involved in the endocytosis and which also involved in the cyclosis, also involved in the metastasis and crowding of cell or motility of cell. The fifth one is a muscle contraction, and sixth one is the cytokinesis. Okay, let us see the endocytosis. We know very well the cell has a important function, that is the endocytosis. In this endocytosis, the cell get folded into inside and takes the outer particle into the inside like this. In this way, it showing the different functions, like it engulfing the pathogenic organisms by the WBC cells and so on. This is the function of endocytosis. Where is the cyclosis? See, in many cells, the cyclosis can be occur. Cyclosis means the streaming of cytoplasm, in the live cell. Means, for example, it is a cell, the cell that contains the internal cytoplasm, that cytoplasm is streaming within the cell like this. For example, if you take the particle, cytoplasm particle lie here, that streaming from here to here, thus it is also looking like this. The movement of cytoplasmic particles within the cell, which is called as a cyclosis. This cyclosis also can be done by the microfilaments. Is it right? The movement of cytoplasm within the cell is called as the cyclosis. That can be done by the microfilaments. That is a very simple. Coming to the metastasis. The metastasis is a condition in the cancer where actually the cancer cells present in a one area, for example liver, that can move from the liver to the other organs like kidney and etc. Whatever the tissue you can take, kidney, heart, like that. So the cancerous cells of native cancer, nothing but liver cancer, from where actually these cells that enter into the kidney cell, where actually the development of cancer will be occur. Actually the liver cancer cells that enter into the kidney cells, where actually kidney cells that converted into the cancer, then also we call such cancer as a liver cancer, not a kidney cancer. So such type of thing, the movement of cancer cells from one place to the another place, or one tissue to the another tissue, can be done by the microfilaments. This process we call as a metastasis. Is it right? Coming to the crowding of cells. We know very well the amoeba, that that crawling, that changing their shape by producing the pseudopodia. Such pseudopodia that contains the microfilaments, especially actin filaments. These actin filaments, which are very essential for the formation of the pseudopodia, this pseudopodia, which is essential for the crawling of cell. For example, this is the substratum. For example, the pseudopodia producing amoeba cells or any cell that are having the crawling capacity, like WBC cells. WBC cells that invagination into the tissue by producing some pseudopodias. Okay, macrophages also producing some pseudopodias. Such pseudopodias that contains the microfilaments. Actually, what happened? For example, this is the surface area. The cell which are present on the surface area, this cell must be transferred or move from here to the here. Then what happened? This cell that produces a protrusion like this onto the surface of this substratum. That surface actually done by the presence of microfilaments. This surface which is leads to this cell movement from here to the here, like this. From here to the here. In this way, the movement or crawling of cell can be done by the microfilaments. Coming to the muscle contraction. The contraction of muscle. Whenever we need, the contraction of muscle will be takes place. That contraction also done by the microfilaments. We will going to see the contraction mechanism by the microfilaments in detail in the upcoming classes. Coming to the cytokinesis, during the cell division, what will happen? The chromosomes which are present in a cell that separated from each other and forms the two nucleus in the cell. In a cell, what happened? The nuclear material is separated, but the cytoplasm which are present in a cell cannot be separated at the end of the cell division. Whenever the cytokinesis will be occur, what happened? The infoldings of plasma membrane can be occur. Finally, it will be extended into in this direction. It leads to the two separate cells. So, what happening here? The separation of the cytoplasm will be takes place for the division of cells into two individual cells. So, such type of mechanism we called as the cytokinesis. Is it right? The cytokinesis can be takes place in all eukaryotic cells. Okay? This is all about the different functions of the actin filaments, actually microfilaments. Is it right? Okay, let us see what is the structure of microfilament. So, the structure of microfilaments, the microfilaments actually, which is made with the combination of the functions what we have discussed in the few minutes before, all these functions can be done by the two important filaments, that is called as the actin filaments and myosin filaments. Actin and myosin, these are the filamentous structures which are both together, they form microfilaments, and all these structures that involved in the different functions what we have discussed. Is it right? Coming to the see what is the structure of actin in this class. Okay, we will going to see the structure of myosin in the upcoming classes. Okay, let us see the structure of actin. Actin is a globular protein. Actually, actin is a globular protein, that is a spherical protein. Is it right? This actin protein actually that contains a binding site, a nuclear site, that is for the binding of a nucleotide that is called as a ATP. Actin protein that bind with the ATP or ADP. ATP or ADP. And also, this actin protein is associated with the magnesium ions. Magnesium ions. So, this is the structure components. What is that? Magnesium ions, ATP or ADP, and globular protein. These three components together that forms the actin protein basically. Now, Let us see how actin protein get associated into form a filament structure. Here the filament is showing that it is a solid rod like structure. Filament, it is nothing but solid rod like structure. So in this solid rod like structure, there is no hollow like structure. Hollow like structure within this filamentous structure. So let us see what happened. For example, I am drawing here. This is a one filament structure of actin. What happened? The actin monomer, another monomer, the monomers of actin protein get combined to form a polymer. So such type of polymer we called as a filament. So let us see, this filament actually contains ATP or ADP. So this is a one filament structure. What happened in previous classes? In microtubule we have discussed. The microtubule that forms the 13 protofilaments together that forms microtubule structure. But here is no 13 protofilaments are present. This is called as a filamentous structure. This is not a protofilament, but the two filaments of actin together twisted. Together they twisted and forms the complete filament structures. Let us see one more. You can see this is the one filamentous structure like this, it going in this direction. See, and here is one more. Like this. What happened? The two individual polymer of actin together they twisted and forms the filament structure. In this way the actin filament is formed. Actually like this, this protein, this monomer of actin also contains the ATP and also ADP, and also that contains the magnesium ions. So this is the structure of actin filament. Again, similarly as like microtubule, it is also contains the positive end and negative end, whereas the positive end is a increased polymerization. And decreased depolymerization. At the positive end, the addition of monomer of actins is more when compared to the deletion of monomers of actin. At the only one place that is called as a positive. This is a very important, many people are confusing here. The positive end only not for the addition. It is also where actually the place where depolymerization or removal of monomers also can be taken. But the addition is more than the deletion. That is more important here to be remembered. Okay, coming to the negative end. The deletion is more, or depolymerization is more than the polymerization. Similarly, it is also same to the same in the microtubule. Here also same, the negative end, where actually depolymerization, deletion of monomer of actin proteins are more when compared to addition of monomers. Here, the 10 times of polymerization at the positive end is more than the negative end. That's why it is called as a positive end and also negative end. Here you have to remember the positive end also occurred at the positive end also depolymerization occurred, at the negative end also polymerization occurred. These are two important things to be remembered. So very, very important point to be remembered. Many times it will be asked. Okay, this is the structure, that positive end and negative end. Then coming to the ATP, what is the function of ATP? In the previous class, we have discussed the GTP that bind, and that is a combination of microtubule structure. Actually, where GTP is essential for the depolymerization, the GTP that convert into the GDP. When the conversion of GTP into GDP, it releases the or breaks the bonds which are present in between the monomers. Like that, here also GTP that converted into the ADP. ATP that converted into the ATP, ADP. So, this conversion which releases some energy, that energy is very essential for the depolymerization, the breaking bonds which are present in between the polymer of filament. The breaking the bonds which are present in between the two monomers, actually. These bonds are broken by the conversion of ATP into the ADP. So, here also remember this point. The ATP conversion in the microfilaments, GTP conversion in the microtubules, which are essential for the depolymerization, which is not essential for the polymerization, more important point to be noted. Many people will be compulsory confused here. The energy actually which needs for the breakdown of bonds, that is a simple. Here the energy which is not useful for the making a bond, it is useful for the breaking a bond, that should be remembered. Okay, this is all about the structure and functions of the microfilaments. Let us see the differences between the microfilaments and the microtubules. Is it right? Actually, the differences between the actin microfilaments and also microtubules, that is the tubulin protein. See, actin filaments and microtubules. Actin filaments, microtubules. Okay, the actin filaments, which are very essential for the many functions what we are write down. But the actin filament is a very short than the microtubules. Here is a very long in length. Long length of microtubules are present, whereas actin filaments are short. Okay, the actin filaments are two polymers together that forms the filament structure. Here, the 13 protofilaments are together that forms the microtubule. The actin filaments that is associated with the ATP, whereas the microtubule that is associated with the GTP. In both, the ATP bond, breakdown of ATP, ATP, which is essential for the GTP breakdown, also essential for the depolymerization. The next point, these two are the polymer. It is also
polymer.
It is involved in the motility of cell, endocytosis and cyclosis and etc. It is involved in the movement of cell. Okay. So it is present in the cytoplasm and muscle cell. Okay, it is present in the cilia and flagella. Okay, so coming here, it is a rod like structure and where is a hollow like structure. So these are the some major important differences between the actin filaments and microtubule filaments. Okay, I hope this is very clear to understand. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR by Info. Don't forget to like, share and comment. Thank you.